Hey, welcome back to Real Fishing and Shooting with Gunner. That sound you hear is the Hornaday Magnum Sonic Cleaner. I use two Sonic Cleaners. Most time it's the Hornaday Magnum. I also have the first Hornaday Cleaner, the little black one that they came out with. It's not heated. You have to use hot water with that. This one, I keep my temperature 145 to 150. And I run them for 50 minutes. Now usually I'll take the basket out when it's done and run it under hot water. Well, since I'm here at this table, I don't have the sink here to do it. So I'm going to try it here in this little pan of hot water. And I'm going to show you a little trick that it's not a trick, it's just the way I do it. I know a lot of people don't use sonic cleaners because the fear of the inside of the case still being damp when they load it, when they put powder in it. I've heard of guys take them out and run them in an oven. All kind of weird things. I got a simple way of doing it that works every time. And it consists of, obviously, the sonic cleaner, then running it under hot water. I don't know how well the hot water in this jar here is going to work, but we're going to try it. And it involves two towels. That's it. Most times, only one towel. But we're going to try this, see how it goes. I'm going to show you real quick how simple this is. All right, we're done. 50 minutes and 30 seconds is what I run them for. So, obviously you shake the cleaning material out of them. Cleaning solution. Now, other than that, I'm going to dump them in here just to get the stuff out of them. Put the basket back in here. I'm going to give you another little tip. A lot of people, well, a few, let's put it this way. The people that do use a sonic cleaner, they'll clean brass, I don't know how much, how many, and then the cleaning solution is very dirty. It's very dirty looking. If you let that, unplug it, shut it off, and let it sit for a couple days, all the dirt and grime will fall to the bottom of the pan. So what you do is, at that time, you actually pour this solution into another container, all except for about the last half inch, and dump that however you get rid of it. This is okay to dump down the sewer. So this goes in the sink. I'll rinse it out, then put the remaining solution back in it. It's still clean. I know I've heard of guys say, well, you know, it's dirty. I clean a couple baskets and then I change it out. Well, you don't have to do that. All right. So here we go. Just put it in some hot water just to get this cleaning solution out of it. Now, what I love about sonic cleaning is real simple. I'm a strong stickler for super clean brass. Couple reasons. One, it runs through your machine so much better, so much smoother. And two, it'll make your dies last longer. So, here's all I do. Clean them out. No, I don't want to do it that way. I'll just put them in here. Now, usually I'm running them in the basket under a faucet of hot water. I don't know how well I can get the majority of the water out this way, but I've never done it this way in a bucket, but just for this video here, I wanted to just be able to give you some kind of example of what I do and how well it works. Okay, this is enough for the video. So anyhow, you got your brass in the towel. Let the towel, see how much water that already absorbed? That's because I didn't have it in the basket to shake it out. But you put it in the towel, let it hang down, roll the towel up, and just do this. Literally, that's all you have to do. I do this for about 3 to 5 minutes. Now where that's a little bit wet from where I first dumped it, come down and let it slide down a little bit to a drier spot. Do it again. Now I don't know how well, trying to make this a quick video. Actually, I know I said I quit saying that. Let me put this out of the way here. And here's the second thing. When it's really wet, you may need a second towel. Make sure you get a nice dry one. Do the same thing. Put it in the middle. Let it hang down. Roll it up. Grab the end. Take it some more. Now, obviously this isn't going to be for 10 minutes that I'm going to do this for you. But this is how I do it. There's a couple of things here. Doing it this way violently shakes the water out of the brass. The towel absorbs it. You may need a second towel, and if you do, that's great. But also, running it back and forth in the towel basically polishes it also. So let me show you why. Look at the inside. That is spotless, and believe it or not, I don't know how well you, yeah, it's not going to focus. That's dry already. Inside. All these are already dry. So, just a simple tip or method. Yeah, that towel's not even wet already. The other towel got it out. But I mean, look, seriously, look how clean inside and out those are. You can't beat this. I mean, it loads so much better. They run through the machine so much better. Hardly any wear and tear on your dies whatsoever. And you don't have the vibration, the loud noise, the dust and lead particles floating around in the air from the tumbler. This is what you end up with. Now, I will say, if it's range brass, there, that's picked up random, five of them. Now, if you've picked up, wait a minute, get these here. Look at that. If I can put the, I don't know how bright that's, yeah, it's gonna be too bright. But as you can see, they almost look like brand new brass. It's never been used, but they have, as you can see. There's a spent primer. What I'm saying is basically less time, less hazardous waste floating around the air if you're really particular about lead particles, less noise, and a much better job. I mean, you don't get a tumbler that cleans the inside out like these also. And literally, they are already dry. I mean, there's nothing, no water on my hand. That's all it took. So if you have a sonic cleaner and didn't use it because of fear of this, this is the way I do it. Works every time. I have never had an issue with it. I am a little bit suspicious, not suspicious. Oh, I can't think of the word now. I'll knock on wood anyhow. So, take your sonic cleaner. Let me show you what I use. Hold on. And because Hornaday is a sponsor, that's why you'll see me use Hornaday products most times. But the Hornaday One Shot Sonic Cleaner. And then when you do gun parts, use their One Shot Sonic Gun Part Cleaner. I will say this. Do not use the brass cleaner on gun parts. I did not know what it would or would not do, so I took the action and the feed ramp and stuff from a Winchester 1400, the whole trigger assembly and everything, and put it in here one day to clean it because it hadn't been cleaned in a while. Let it go 50 minutes, 100, I think I had it 145 or 150 degrees. When I took it out, it was absolutely spotless, including all bluing and paint. I was back down to the bare metal. So it all got frog lube like crazy, which is basically all I use. When I have to clean up scratches or polish, I use Flitz, but I only use frog lube for everything. Cleaner, lubricant, protector. I've been using it now for over 2 years. Ran my AR 1200 rounds, cleaned the AR, treated it with frog lube, ran it 1200 rounds, took it back apart. The carbon, what little was there, came off on the brown paper towel part. And if you've ever tore apart an AR or shoot one, you know the little mushroom section of the firing pin. Most people scrape that with a knife, a blade, or a screwdriver. In fact, they even sell a tool to scrape the carbon off that. With the frog lube, the carbon came off of my fingers when I was taking it out of the bolt. That's no lie. The frog lube is that good. I have not oiled the AR in 2 years. It's only been frog lube. Now, I use both the liquid. Although I don't have a tub of the paste here, I put one little jar to carry around with me. I use liquid and paste combination. The trick is to heat it up. Now, I will tell you, you can use a hair dryer, takes a little longer. I am not sponsored by Wagner, have no affiliation with them whatsoever. I bought this at Lowe's, I think, for $24. It literally only takes 15 seconds, and your part's almost too hot to hold. It makes a big difference. But anyhow, I'm getting off track. Sonic cleaner, if you have one and were afraid to use it, use it. If you were thinking of one, get one. Now, again, what I was saying earlier, I don't think I finished. If I go pick out old range brass that's been outdoors and it's really, really filthy, yes, I'll tumble that. Usually I have to tumble it once, tumble it for a few hours, get it clean. After that, it's just all sonic clean. So, I am going to recommend the Magnum Sonic Cleaner from Hornaday. You can control the time and the temperature. I love it. It's all I've been using. And you, too, can have brass that clean, that dry, that quick. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll catch you later this week. We got a couple more videos coming.